The purpose of this Headless Professor video is to show how to use JASP to deal with a comparison of two separate groups. I start off with my data that are here in a Google Sheets file. And I got a group of males in rows 11 through 36, and a group of females in rows 37 through 60, total of 50 subjects. And I've got some of my descriptives down here at the bottom. I found out that the male social class is a little bit lower than the female social class, and I want to see if that's going to be significant. Well, let's start by downloading this file from Google Sheets, and we're going to download as a CSV. That's the kind of file that JASP has to work with. So we download that, and we're going to take this file and we're going to modify it. So I'm going to save it again, and I'm going to save it as Midlife Crisis, which is what the topic is about, and I'll put JASP afterwards. Now right now I have my first few rows describing how I did my coding. I'm going to get that out of the way. Although on our original file, that information is still there if I need it. I used column A for different variables and explanations. I'm going to get that out of the way by deleting that. And then down on the bottom, I had some information about descriptives. I'm going to get all of that out of the way too, so that all we have now in this cleaned up file is we have the different variables, and we're going to use column A for our grouping, males, females, and we're going to look at column C as the variable that we want to compare males and females on. So I have my first row for the labels, and then I have my 50 subjects data in rows 2 through 51. Okay, that looks good. So I'm going to save that as my file for JASP. So I will close this. And now I will get into JASP. There's the JASP icon. And it opens up. I go up to File, Open, from the computer, Browse, and here's my JASP file. There it opens up. And it identifies the first variable as a categorical, male and female. And we've got to tell it that social class, we're going to try to treat it as a ratio scale. It's really ordinal. Let's treat it as a ratio. Okay, let's click on t-test. This would be an independent samples, what I call separate groups. Let's see how that would work. So the dependent variable is going to be social class, and the grouping variable is whether the subjects are male or female. Notice with JASP, they immediately do the calculations, and here it is. That's the p-value right there. That's not going to be significant. But look at what else you can get. You can see some other tests, like the Mann-Whitney test, which is actually a better test because the data are originally in an ordinal format. Let's throw in a Mann-Whitney test and see what happens. Well, the Mann-Whitney test is not showing significance either. You can also get things like effect size to get our Cohen's d. So we can get all of this information here. I think the Mann-Whitney and the t-test are the most important, and of course I could copy that right to my clipboard, boom, and I got it right now, and I could paste it right into my essay. Well, that's how JASP would work. And I'm saving the JASP file.